Hi everyone, and mag-uusap na naman tayo about skincare, skincare, and skincare. And as you can see, medyo special set ulit tayo because we're going to be talking about a topic that requires derma answers. And true enough, meron tayong derma dito, of course, our OG. I'm so happy to have you, Dr. Gail. This is Dr. Gail Robredo Vitas.
I'm very, very excited and of course honored again to do a collab with the OG.
The OG, talaga. For this video, Doc, ang pag-uusapan natin is something na concern ng community. Especially since nasa tropical country tayo like the Philippines, isa talaga sa pressing issue natin is yung hyperpigmentation. Or I guess in layman's terms, mga hindi alam ng meaning nun, yung pag-darken or pag-discolor ng skin. Hindi lang sa face natin, pero minsan sa elbows, sa knees, sa kilikili, sa under eyes. So initially, anong thoughts mo sa ganitong concerns or skin concerns ng community?
Tama yung sinabi mo, no? Because we live in a tropical country and malakas yung araw, mas marami talaga nagkakaroon ng hyperpigmentation o yung pagda-darken ng skin. And to add to that dyan, kasi our skin type also, we belong to the skin type 4, wherein mas prone tayo, mas marami tayong melanin on the skin. So that pag naarawan tayo, na-expose tayo sa sun, nagda-darken talaga siya. Compared to individuals with lighter skin types, na parang pag nagbilad sila, namumula lang, and then babalik na naman sila sa dating color nila.
Yung ganito kasing concern, a lot of people are thinking, ah, skin whitening ba yung kailangan? Pero I think it's not really a skin whitening thing. Parang hindi naman natin i-change yung natural skin tone natin, kumbaga ipapantay lang natin.
Well, kami nowadays, parang we prefer to use the terms brightening. Kumbaga ayaw naman nilang baguhin yung skin tone nila, gusto lang nila na mas even siya para mas radiant, mas younger, mas fresh yung appearance. And I think that's what we want to emphasize then when we give treatments to our patients. What we want to do is for you to have clear skin, less blotchy, more evenly toned, etc.
So para ma-organize natin yung flow, we will be talking about yung iba't ibang mga areas of the body and yung different causes and mga treatments nila. Maglalagay na lang ako ng mga timestamps for you guys to be able to fast forward to your specific skin concern. Alright, so Doc, start muna tayo with, of course, yung unang nakikita talaga ng mga tao, which is yung dark spots on the face. Parang after mo magka-breakout, diba, it's really the most, parang pinaka-prone ka talaga to mga dark spots like these. What are some common reasons kung bakit yung mga dark spots from acne take longer than usual to fade?
To heal. Well, sige, let's give muna background on how pigmentation forms after a skin condition or a trauma. So we call it post-inflammatory hyperpigmentation. Dahil nga, yung mga nabanggit natin kanina na we have dark skin type, so meron tayong, marami tayong melanin on the skin. Talagang lahat tayo na-expose sa sun kasi nga we live in a tropical country. So, when things happen to the skin like inflammation, acne, or kahit nga ano lang, nakamot mo lang, di ba? Pag nag-heal siya, nagkakaroon siya ng pigmentation. So, one of the causes is number one, yun nga, sun exposure. Number two, a lot of melanin on the skin. And number three, the amount of inflammation. So, yung tanong mo, bakit yung acne mas matagal mag-heal, yung pigmentation? Kasi, mas grabe yung inflammation niya compared to other, like for example, nagaskas ka lang, ganyan. So, yun yung most of the time, that's why nga, parang may patient na may acne, ini-encourage talaga namin to get treatment. Kasi the more inflammation, the more prone you are to scarring, dispigmentation, etc.
Another thing na very curious ako about, kasi hindi lang dark spots from acne yung concern ng iba. Minsan, kunyari galing ka sa araw, meron ka ng mga sunspots, or for our audiences na medyo older na, yung mga age spots na nakikita. Ano kaya yung possible causes ng mga ganun?
Actually, di ba the sun, we love the sun, it gives us a lot of benefits. Pero mayroon kasi tayong tinatawag na photo-aging. When I tell my patients to get sun protection, it's not really just because I don't want their skin to darken. What happens kasi is when we expose our skin sa UV radiation, it causes DNA damage. And yun yung ayaw natin. Kasi DNA damage, apart from causing, you know, pigmentation, it can cause age signs like wrinkles, fine lines, large pores, and yung mga nakikita natin na patche-patche ng parang mga brown, mapa-mapa ng mga brown.
Yes.
So, those are actually caused by cumulative exposure to UV radiation and aging.
Meaning, Doc, parang continuous silang nabilad sa araw, nag-accumulate na yung sun damage on their skin.
Oo. And alam mo dyan, di ba yung iba sinasabi, eh bakit, Doc, nag-a-apply na naman ako ng sunscreen, ba't nagkakaroon pa rin ako niyan? It's important to know that whatever happens to your skin, product yan ng years and years mo.
Of pagpapabaya.
Yeah. So, years of not applying sunscreen, years of neglecting your skin. Kasi, syempre, pag bata ka pa, wala, perfect, flawless ka talaga eh. So, you take it for granted. Ay, hindi ko kailangan magtanggal ng makeup. Ay, hindi ko kailangan mag-sunscreen.
So, little by little, nagbe-build up siya. And then, in the end, may kita mo na lang.
Yes. So, I always say, 10 to 15 years, and then it will start to come out.
What do you think, Doc, are the best ways para ma-prevent natin yung dark spots from happening in the first place? Specifically sa face.
Una-una, sunscreen use talaga is very, very important. Sun protection is also crucial kasi we know naman that no sunscreen blocks UV radiation 100%, diba?
Yes.
Sun protection meaning using protective clothing, avoiding, you know, direct exposure, seeking shade. Those are important. Sayang lahat ng effort eh. Lahat ng effort natin for anti-aging, for anti-pigmentation if we don't protect our skin from UV radiation, which is the number one cause of aging and pigmentation. Pag may pigmentation issue kasi yung patient, I like to exfoliate. Even just using mga glycolic acid toners or PHA toners. Kasi mas pinapamadali niya yung pagpalit ng balat natin. So, mas madaling mag-slough off yung mga layers ng skin that might contain the pigmentation. And then, on top of that, I like also to give mga tyrosinase inhibitors. Carbetin, kojic acid, your even your hydroquinone sometimes. But hydroquinone has to be given by a doctor, ha? Not the ones that you get outside, etc. And then, I also like to give retinoids. Retinoids kasi, diba, they regulate skin turnover. They also have anti-pigmentation properties. Plus, kasi remember, UV radiation is also DNA damaging. So, nakokorrect ng retinol some of the damage caused by UV radiation. And then you can also add antioxidants.
Antioxidants.
So, antioxidants kasi...
They
can boost your sun protection from your sunscreen. They can also protect you from DNA damage from UV radiation. And they can also be soothing and anti-inflammatory. So, yun yung apat ko na binibigay pag meron talagang pigmentation issue. Sunscreen, retinoids, antioxidants, and tyrosinase inhibitors.
Parang in a way, Doc, mas okay just to get maybe a skincare product na well-rounded. Marami sa atin, Doc, iniisip natin you can only get this one ingredient in this one serum. Pero marami ngayon parang kinukombine na nila,
yes.
Diba? Like, minsan nga yung retinol may niacinamide.
Correct.
Na. May alpha-arbutin na. So,
vitamin C and niacinamide. May ganun din.
Ito, Doc, yung gusto kong itanong sa'yo. Like, marami akong gusto kong itanong about melasma. So, let's move on to that next. This is actually a topic kasi na hindi ko siya masyadong tinatakal sa channel ko, Doc. Because I, as someone na hindi pa naka-experience ng melasma, ayoko rin magbigay ng input na something na wala akong experience. How could you explain melasma in layman's terms? Yes.
So, melasma is actually, it's a complex pigmentation issue. Nangyayari siya, it appears on the face. Most commonly, pwede rin siya sa body, pero dahil nga exposed yung face, mas sa face siya. Number one, pinaka main cause niya is UV radiation. Kasi UV radiation stimulates melanin production, it destroys yung DNA ng skin natin, and it also compromises our skin barrier. Number two, hormones. Contributory factor din yung hormones. Kaya, di ba, usually, pag nabubuntis, or mas common siya sa females, kasi estrogen plays a big factor in melasma. And then number two, sometimes when you use like cosmetics and perfumes, tapos sa mukha mo sinispray, tapos naaarawan ka, it can contribute to melasma. So, it's usually a map-like, para siyang patch, big patch na brown. More commonly found, forehead, nose, cheeks. Kasi yun talaga yung natatamaan ng araw. Diba? So, di ba parang naka-ano siya?
Parang may mask ka of pigment.
Yun. Parang may mask ka ng pigment. And it's very complex. Until now, hindi pa rin talaga napipinpoint kung ano talaga yung main cause ng melasma. We all know that there are a lot of contributing factors. But kung parang, ano Doc talaga yung main cause, number one? Hindi natin alam. And I have a lot of patients with melasma from using products containing irritating ingredients. So yung mga, di ba natin nauso yung mga sets na maraming glycolic, lactic, retinoid, hydroquinone, all in one, tapos sobrang bakbakbakbaka, tapos after 2 weeks, ang ganda na ng skin mo. So, some patients who use those kinds of combination ingredients, they come back with melasma. In some patients, melasma is not merely a pigmentation issue. Meron din siyang, makikita mo, di ba, pag may melasma, may mga broken capillaries or blood vessels, ganun. So, naisip nila na parang these blood vessels also play a role in maintaining the melasma. So, meron different types of melasma. Merong epidermal melasma, merong dermal, merong combination. Tapos meron tayong, hindi ko alam kung ako lang nag-invento nito, vascular melasma. Yun na nga yung mga patients. Sa pagtingnan mo up close, it's not just pigmentation, but there are a lot of like broken capillaries and like red marks, ganyan. Marami siyang factors, and the way we target it, the way we address it, is by using a lot of products, like the four that I mentioned earlier. And ngayon kasi merong bagong game changer, tranexamic acid. I'm sure you've heard of it.
Oh, okay. Do you mean yung topical or yung pinapahid or yung oral na tinatake talaga as pills?
Well, most of the studies were done on oral.
Oral.
Well, talking about melasma, diba?
Yes.
So for melasma, it's really more the oral form. Hindi ko din na-mention kanina dyan, parang there's also another laser that I like to use for melasma, especially yung mga may vascular.
Sorry, doc. Vascular meaning yung ugat-ugat.
Yes, oo. Okay. Kasi diba parang, diba matagal na ako in practice. So sometimes, pag meron ako mga tinitreat na melasma, hindi siya completely nawawala, especially pag meron ka mga broken capillaries, ganyan. Kasi yun pala, kailangan mo rin siyang tanggalin kasi it feeds the pigment. So there's another laser that I use. It's called the yellow laser. Depending on what type of melasma, I can interchange between like the purely pigment and then the yellow laser. So yun, kailangan talaga i-examine. Kailangan talaga magpatingin yung patient.
Is there any way to prevent melasma?
Meron naman. Ako nga, dahil yung mom ko may melasma, sobrang ingat ko talaga with sun exposure. Hindi naman sa takot ako sa araw, pero give your skin ample protection. The way to prevent it is really to protect your skin from UV radiation, from using irritating products na patong-patong na talagang pulang-pula na yung balat mo. Yun yung mga usual na pwede mong gawin to minimize or prevent melasma. And the use of products that are, you know, tyrosinase inhibitors.
Ano nun talaga, Doc, no? When it comes to melasma, at the end of the day, different causes, different factors that cause melasma. Mm-hmm. And there are different types of melasma. So,
and different treatments din.
And different treatments din. So parang it's really best to be assessed by a derm when it comes to this.
And ako dyan, palagi ko sinasabi, di ba? Parang a lot of patients come to us. Mm. Na grabe na. Kung nag-consult na sana sila at the start, they would have saved a lot of time. Money.
Kasi products, yeah, Doc, diba? Ang diba? Dami. Try.
And yung skin nila, na-save nila, diba? Kasi pag parang, Doc, ang dami ko nang na-try. O diba, i-compute mo yung mga nagastos mo sa kakabili ng products. Sana nag-consult ka na lang, diba?
Ang dami mong natipid sana. In the end, at least alam mo yung exact na situation ng skin mo, diba? And yung mga treatments na kailangan.
Malay mo, hindi lang pala melasma yung skin issue mo, diba?
Oo, actually, diba? Alright, so ito naman next, Doc. This is a skin issue that is a bit close to home for me. Mm-hmm. Kasi nasa lahi namin to, which is dark under eyes. Kasi diba, Doc, ang explanation sa akin, iba-iba din yung causes ng dark under eyes. Hindi lang siya yung kulang katulog.
Yes.
A lot of different causes kung paano daw tumatama yung light sa face mo, yung pigment talaga, and also yung genetics mo, kung paano puffy yung mata mo. So, I guess i-discuss na lang namin ni Doc, keeping into mind na maraming iba't ibang mga factors that cause yung darkening sa under eyes. Is it usually just, ito yung main factor mo? Or is it also, ito, tsaka ito, tsaka ito? Like, maraming factors. Ano siya usually, Doc?
Minsan combination siya.
Combination talaga.
Minsan combination. Like, bilang may dark under eyes din. And, naintindihan ko yung concern mo kasi a lot of people kasi look tired. Ako, minsan, haba-haba ng tulog ko sa pag-gisi ko, diba, item, parang feeling.
Same, Doc.
Diba,
oh my God.
Puyat ka. Parang ganun,
oh, diba? Oo, you look tired. Tapos ako parang, Nina, 7 hours naman natulog.
Uh-oh.
Parang, ano ba?
Okay, sabihin mo, oo nga kasi puyat ako. Pero actually, hindi naman, diba? When it comes to like factors, okay, number one, genetics. Genetics plays talaga a big factor. So kung, di ba, usually pag, like you said, nasa lahi nyo, di ba? Totoo yun, I believe that. Pagka-dark ng under eyes kasi natin, pwedeng pigment, meaning talagang itim siya. Maganda siya in a way because it's easily addressed. You can address it with lightening creams, even lasers, ganyan, chemical peel. Number two is yung thin skin dito and the blood vessels underneath. So as we get older, kasi nababawasan tayo ng fats dito, di ba? And it thins out that area of the skin, exposing a little bit of what's underneath. And that's why when you're puyat, mas engorge yung blood vessels mo, di ba? So mas visible.
Tapos ibang factor pa, Doc, yung puffiness, di ba? Kapag medyo puffy yung mata mo sa umaga na pagising mo.
Oh, gravity naman yun, di ba?
Gravity
because
naman.
Nakahiga ka, di ba? So naipon dyan yung ano. Ako ganun ako, miss puffy ako. Kaya I don't like shooting in the morning.
Kasi hindi ko malas na kasi parang, manas, diba? Na manas is, yeah, very, very that.
Meron pa pala akong hindi na-mention. Like, for example, kung prone to allergies ka, di ba yung mga ano, may allergic rhinitis, ayun, medyo talagang dark yung dito mo.
My God, ako rin yun doon.
So ako, ganun ako, allergic rhinitis, tapos manipis na yung balat kasi kita yung blood vessels, ganyan, tapos lahi pa, di ba? So, yeah, it can be multifactorial.
It can be multifactorial.
But it's important to know kung ano talaga yung cause. Kasi doon mo siya properly ma-address. Kasi yung parang, try nga natin to, try natin. Mamaya ma-irritate pa yung eyes mo, di. PIH naman yun. If you really want to address it, I suggest you go to your dermatologist to talk about your options.
Pero feeling ko kasi, Doc, sa community ngayon, people tend to expect a lot from their eye creams. So, siguro i-set the record straight na natin siya, Doc. Ano ba yung may expect natin when we use, una, mga regular eye creams, and second, yung may mga, let's say, anti-aging daw, mga retinol. What can we expect from these products?
Well, usually kasi eye creams, they don't contain as high a concentration of active products versus face creams. Kasi ito yung pinakamanipis na balat natin sa katawan natin, ito. So normally, if you have an anti-aging eye cream, for example lang ha, yung face cream mo has retinol 0.5% or 1%. Your eye cream will probably have like a 0.1. Sobrang konti niya because nga, mas delicate yung area niya. And yun yung usually yung mga nasa eye creams, yung mga products that target those specific problems. So for me, hindi siya necessary. Like, for me, not everyone should have an eye cream. Let's put it at that na lang. But if you have specific issues around the eye area that you want to target, better yung eye creams. Kasi they are specifically made for those issues. And the ingredients that are used are tailor-fitted to the delicate skin structure around the eyes.
But for you, Doc, hindi naman siya requirement?
For me, hindi siya necessary. For me.
Meron din ba tayong mga preventative measures? Let's say yung mga iba, wala pa silang dark under eyes or maybe bata pa sila. Are there any ways to prevent it?
Ganun pa rin. Skincare and sun protection. Tapos ako, ito pa yung isang ano, yung rubbing. You have to be gentle dun sa skin ng eyes mo. Especially yung mga palagi nag-makeup and then vigorous yung pagtanggal ng makeup. Yun. Kasi syempre, ano din, nasa-stretch yung skin ng eye mo.
Okay, ito naman, Doc, move tayo from the face, move naman tayo to
sa body. Okay.
Yes. So ito, Doc, insecurity to ng marami, which is yung mga dark skin folds. So hindi lang yung fold na nakikita natin dito na sa kilikili, but also yung sa singit. So yung skin natin na may folds, Doc, how is it different from yung skin natin na, for example, may kita natin dito or yung sa face natin?
Well, number one, it's prone to friction. Kasi nasa fold siya, di ba? Friction, moisture, which are actually contributory factors kung ba't nangingitim sila. Kasi di ba, yung skin natin, pag palagi siyang, alam mo yun, may gasgas ganyan, it protects itself by thickening itself. So, in thickening, umiitim siya. So, yung kilikili, sometimes di ba sa leg din, pag medyo, pag gumagamit ka ng, palagi kang gumagamit ng may collar or lanyards, medyo nangingitim din siya. Singit din when you wear like, panties or briefs na alam mo yun,
very
may
tight.
Tas may friction, di ba? So yun yung big difference niya. And then number two, it's more prone to pag namo-moist siya. Kasi syempre, so madali siyang masugat. So madaling, di ba minsan pag nag-gain ka ng weight, minsan tas nagkikis-kisan siya. So masugat siya. So una-una, yung exposure niya compared to this is different because fold siya, friction, and moisture. So, kailangan talaga iniingatan siya. Tapos, di ba, like yung underarms, for example, my hair. Tapos, yung sweat glands natin in these areas are different from our sweat glands sa body part. And they secrete a kind of milky sweat with proteins that when they interact with bacteria, mabaho. Kaya, di ba, yung iba may tinatawag na anghit. So, that's from your sweat mixing with bacteria that gives that smell.
In terms of yung pag-darken ng kilikili natin and yung singit, na medyo mabilis talaga siya mag-darken compared to the other parts of our skin. Pero, hindi naman siya natatama ng araw necessarily, di ba? Parang nakatago pa nga siya eh, di ba? If anything. So, why does it easily darken despite not being exposed sa araw?
Kasi marami tayong melanin on the skin. So, bilang skin types 4, we have a lot of melanin on the skin. So, minsan pag nasasugat tayo, mas madali siya mag-darken talaga.
Mas prone lang talaga tayo.
Mas prone. Kaya iba, di ba, pag napansin mo, like, especially our Caucasian friends, hindi talaga sila nag-darken, di ba? Minsan kahit paano gawin treatment, mamumula lang sila and then puti ulit. Because nga, yung melanin sa skin nila, hindi yung dark melanin like us.
So, kunyari, Doc, meron ako nakitang pigmentation dito or may konting darkening na. What do you suggest are the first steps na dapat natin gawin?
Pinaka-importante, kung kaya mo ha, to try to find out kung bakit siya nangitim in the first place. Kasi hindi naman yan ano eh, hindi naman yung parang pagising mo, ay, may itim na, di ba? Parang, it's normally a gradual process. And one of the more common causes talaga is irritation from products that you use.
Like deodorant?
Yes. Oh. Deodorants, whitening creams, whatnot, di ba yung mga ganun. So kung napansin mo, kasi hindi naman yan parang pag nilagay mo yun, bukas may itim na eh.
Yes.
Normally, yung pigmentation from the products you use come from irritation. So minsan nilagay mo, tas kumate, namula, so mamaya may itim na. That's one. Number two, another cause would be parang from plucking or waxing. Kasi anything that your skin perceives as trauma can translate to post-inflammatory hyperpigmentation or darkening. Number two, friction. Halimbawa, runner ka or like nag-workout ka sa laging ganun or medyo you're on the heavy side and maraming friction that can also lead to pigmentation. And then number four, ano ba yung number four? Using of products that give you like a subacute irritant contact dermatitis. Like for example, if you're on the sensitive side, tapos yung mga damit mo lahat may Fabcon. Tapos na pagpawisan, lumipat sa balat mo, na-irritate. Yung mga ganun. Kasi not all irritations naman namumula nangangati. Minsan biglang mamaya, gradually nag-darken na lang siya. So you have to find out which among those could be the cause. And then eventually, if you put a stop to the cause, mag-lighten naman yung underarms mo, eventually. Meron din tayo mga ibang factors. Siyempre, like, may mga conditions, like for example, pag nabubuntis, diba, hormones, hormonal imbalance, or yung mga on the heavier side, kuminsan meron silang yung condition called acanthosis nigricans, which is like the darkening and thickening of skin folds. So those are different naman, separate din yun. So yun na nga, again, if you're not able to determine, pinaka number one pa rin talaga to consult. Kasi we will help you assess kung ano ba talaga yung possible causes.
So on the skincare side, Doc, kunyari, yun na, may nakita na tayong darkening of the skin folds and parang na-pinpoint na natin yung cause. For example, deodorant, let's say. What skincare products or skincare ingredients could we incorporate para malighten yung skin folds? Especially, taking into account na medyo mas sensitive yung mga folds natin.
So, number one, pag na-identify mo na yung cause, so put a stop to it. Siyempre, kung halimbawa sabi mo kung deodorant, either palitan mo or, you know, don't use it at all. And then, like we talked about earlier, yung skin folds kasi medyo subjected siya to different types of, alam mo tawag doon, trauma and exposures compared to our normal skin. So ako, use gentle cleansers, avoid, like ang dami kasing pag may darkening, sinascrub nila lang vigorously or inexfoliate nila, which can actually make the pigmentation worse. So treat it gently, don't use irritating ingredients. You can even use soothing ingredients. Marami na kasi ngayon in the market na antiperspirants and deodorants with like soothing ingredients like niacinamide, sometimes even, I don't know, like ceramides or something. So, kung alam mo na nga na yung cause mo is friction and whatever, ganun. So, use gentle ingredients that support the barrier and can even lighten the skin in a gentle way. Like niacinamide is a good ingredient to apply on those delicate areas.
Kojic acid,
yeah,
Doc.
Pwede.
Pero Doc, ang dilemma ng marami, kojic acid gusto nilang gamitin. Oh. Pero, kojic soap lang, na medyo drying din.
Hindi, kasi ang problema doon, kung ang habol mo lang yung kojic acid, huwag naman in soap form. Kasi soaps have surfactants eh. So, pag iniwan mo yan dyan, hindi lang yung kojic acid yung mag-work, pati yung surfactants. So, yung mga, yung barrier makompromise.
So, parang na-cancel yung, ano, in
or
a way.
Or parang mas na-irritate siya. I mean, I'm not against kojic bars or whatever. Pero kung ang habol mo doon yung kojic acid, better to use na lang something that you leave on. Kasi di ba yung iba, parang ibababad ko, Doc, yung katawan ko ng 5 minutes para ma-absorb yung kojic. But the surfactants are there. And they're irritating. So the longer the surfactants stay on your skin, the more of your lipid barrier natatanggal.
So better, Doc, siguro kojic lotion.
Oh yeah, kojic cream, mga ganyan.
Actually, Doc, meron na nga ngayon mga kojic serums eh. So
kojic acid is actually a good ingredient, ako ha, yes. In my opinion.
Like, so ito naman, Doc, yung next natin, very concerning din ito for a lot of us, which is yung darkening sa batok. Ito sometimes yung ibang tao covered naman ng hair nila or covered naman ng collar nila. Though that could also cause kapag may friction, di ba, Doc? Pero ano yun, Doc? Ano yung mga main causes usually kapag may darkening sa batok? Kasi ang specific niya, Doc, eh.
Yun nga, tama yung sinabi mo. It could also be from friction, like if you're always using mga collared shirts or like yung mga lanyards, diba, from your IDs. But meron kasing condition called acanthosis nigricans. I don't know if you've heard about it. So yung acanthosis nigricans, yun nga, it's a pigmented, velvety, thick part of the skin. And it's usually correlated with being overweight and insulin resistance. So hindi naman ibig sabihin pag may ganun ka na, may insulin resistance ka na. But usually kasi, you would find it in overweight individuals. Yung mga more on the heavy side. And you would find that pag nag-try sila mag-lose weight, umayat sila, nagdi-disappear din siya.
Nawala.
And it's not just on the batok, ha. You can also find it in the groin, underarms, ganyan, other areas. Sometimes nga dito pa eh, meron pa akong patient na meron dito.
So sometimes yung iba, Doc, no, parang akala nila baka irritation, baka yung pala acanthosis, or maybe even both, diba, Doc?
So pag ganun, ano, parang most patients will try to scrub it, alam mo yung sakalangan nila, dumi. So pag acanthosis, nigricans, I really encourage that you consult. Kasi there are other factors involved and it's not just, you know, pigment. Ang hirap kasi manghula. Like when you describe it, like written, parang ang hirap i-imagine kasi mamaya iba pala yung imagination ko dun sa actual.
And speaking of, Doc, actually, di ba yung sabi mo sa batok, medyo iba na yung parang causes niya talaga. Something similar or a body part na similar sa ganito, as I've heard, correct mo na lang ako, Doc, kung mali ako, are yung elbows and yung knees natin, which is actually yung next natin na pag-uusapan. Eto, Doc, naririnig ko sa ibang mga dermatologists na yung cause niya is a little bit different because it's not necessarily yung parang hyperpigmentation na same sa face natin,
yes,
or yung parang na-irritate,
correct,
from something. So ano ba, Doc, specifically yung cause kapag nagda-darken yung elbows and knees natin?
Well, yung pinaka-common na nakikita ko, ha, yung mga nag-work sa office tapos laging nakaganon. Like, laging nakapatong yung elbow sa table. Kasi if you look at your elbow, di ba, buto yan. And then pinatong pa siya sa hard surface. So yung skin natin, it's smart eh. When it feels like may trauma or anything na parang bad for it, it protects itself. So when you are naka-like that all the time, parang you're receiving trauma from your bone and the table, di ba? So yung skin, ang reaction niya, pakapalin niya yung sarili niya.
To protect?
Yes. And because of that, maitim siya. Kasi kumakapal yung balat, no? And sinasabi ko rin sa patients, kasi I do get some patients, parang daw ang itim ng siko ko. Pag stretch mo, tapos even yung color, hindi siya maitim. Kasi normally, when it's like that, syempre nag-bunch up yung skin natin, it will appear dark. Pero hindi tunay na dark yun.
Parang yun, ano lang talaga, parang illusion in a way.
Yes, parang ganun. Same with the knees. So normally, yung mga nakukuha kong patients na may dark knees, yung may mga activities sila that involve like kneeling on the floor, like mga ballerina, sometimes dancers.
Yes.
Di ba, ang dami nilang mga movement sa floor, yes, athlete sometimes. Magla-lighten siya even if you don't do anything about it, if you stop what's causing it. Like, if you stop doing that, eventually with time, magla-lighten din siya. Pero yun, medyo matagal. Very common yan. Ang usually, binibigay ko siya ng exfoliant. Exfoliant more than lightening because most of the time, the darkening is not really pigment. It's more thickened skin.
Thickened skin. So, ano, Doc? Mainly, di ba, pag top layer, glycolic acid, yung mga ganun.
Mm-hmm. And even keratolytics pala, pwede rin, like urea.
Actually, Doc, medyo curious nga ako dun about urea eh, kasi it's a skincare ingredient na hindi masyado na pag-uusapan.
Yeah, I know.
Di ba, parang feeling ko, Doc, underrated siya.
Yes.
Di ba?
Yung urea kasi, it's a humectant.
So, hydrating?
Oo, up to a certain percentage. Okay, so usually mga 4 to 10%, even 20. Pero pag lumabas siya ng 20, keratolytic na siya. So, up to a certain percent, it's considered a moisturizer, specifically a humectant. But after that, it's a keratolytic na.
I see. So, specifically, Doc, for elbows and knees, what percentage do you think would be best?
30 to 40, I would probably, if you want to use urea.
So, Doc, kapag ano ba, 8 to 10% yung gamitin mo on your elbows and knees, is it ineffective na? Or
may
use pa rin?
Kasi it can also soften.
So may konting benefit pa rin siya. But it would be better yung mga 30% to,
if you want to nipis.
And I think that's it. That's all the questions that we have for Doc Gale. Yay! Alam nyo guys, palaban talaga to si Doc Gale kapag sumasagot tayo ng questions. Medyo natakot ako kasi ang dami talaga nating questions. Huwag na lang natin i-zoom. Pero Doc Gale, again, thank you so much.
Thank you, John.
Ayan, I'm so happy to have you in this video to inform
long
our
overdue
viewers.
Ko
sobrang long overdue talaga. For those who want to see your content, for those who want to interact with you as a dermatologist, where could we find you?
Una-una, thank you, Jan, for inviting me to your channel. And si Jan talaga, one of those, he actually taught me how to do a lot of things when I was just doing everything by myself. So thank you. I'm on YouTube as Dr. Gale Redovitas and on Instagram as @IreneGale and TikTok din as @IreneGale.
And for those na baka gustong mag-collab kami ulit, if you have any other topics that you want us to talk about, just let us know in the comments, yung mga requests ninyo. So this is goodbye for now. Pero we will see each other again soon in another video.
Bye, guys!